Good morning, everyone. Welcome to St. Aloysius Parish on this 33rd Sunday in Ordinary Time. It's the World Day of the Poor. We welcome our celebrant this morning, Father Frankie Geary, as well as all of you watching from your homes. Readings this morning may be found on page 540 of your Sunday Missal. I invite everyone to stand for our opening hymn, number 719, Blessed are the Pure of Heart.
Today we offer Mass for Giovanni, Brigida, Lisi, Taylor, and Anne Snow. And I would like to offer this Mass for a personal intention I have. Dear brothers and sisters, as we begin, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have received
in my thoughts and my words,
in my mind, in
my heart,
through my own fault.
Therefore, I ask,
just as Mary, the Virgin,
all the angels and saints,
and you, my brothers and sisters,
to pray for me
under the power of God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace to the Lord of good will. We praise you,
we bless you,
we adore you,
we glorify you,
we give you thanks to the great Lord. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father,
Lord Jesus Christ, only God's Son,
Lord God, and our God,
Son of the Father,
you take away
Let us pray, O Lord, our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
In the same way, the one who had the two talents made two more talents. But the one who had received the one talent went off and dug a hole in the ground and hid his master's money, After a long time, the master of those slaves came and settled account with them. Then the one who had received the five talents came forward, bringing five more talents, saying, "Master, you handed over to me five talents. See, I have gained five more talents." His master said to him, "Well done, good and trustworthy slave. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter the glory of your master." And the one of the two talents also came forward, saying, "Master, you handed over to me two talents. See, I have made two more talents." His master said to him, "Well done, good and trustworthy slave. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master." Then the one who had received the one talent also came forward, saying, "Master, I knew that you were a harsh man, reaping where you did not sow, and gathering where you did not scatter seed. So I was afraid, and I went and hid your talent in the ground. Here, you are what is yours." But his master replied, "You wicked and lazy slave, you knew, did you, that I reap where I did not sow, and gather where I did not scatter? Then you ought to have invested my money with the bankers, and on my return, I would have received what was my own interest. So take the talents from him and give it to the one of the 10 talents. For to all those who have, more will be given, and they will have an abundance. But from those who have nothing, even what they have will be taken away. As for this worthless slave, throw him into the outer darkness, where they will be weeping and gnashing of teeth." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So today is 33rd Sunday in ordinary time, so we are approaching the end of the liturgical year. So we will see, as we have heard last Sunday, that the reading slowly will lead us to the Advent season. So during the coming Sunday, until the end of the liturgical year, the reading will emphasize the need or the invitation to be alert for the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Last Sunday we had our reading of the wise bridegroom. Today we have the reading of the talents. And last Sunday the reading emphasized the need to be vigilant. And they also struck us with a stone of hope that invites us to always seek the divine wisdom. So we have the book of wisdom as first reading last Sunday. As we wait, we are called really to practice wisdom. And as we wait, Christ's wisdom will make us understand some realities that tend to make us losing hope. And by practicing wisdom, we'll be able to identify those elements. That's why today the Gospel commands us to use our talents as we wait for the coming of our Lord. And St. Paul, in the second reading, brothers and sisters, says, "For yourself, know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night." But he has to give us hope, even though that day is coming, that's like the return of the man who gave those talents to his slave. He returned before telling them when and how he just came, show up. But St. Paul says, "You, beloved, is not in darkness, for that day to surprise you like a thief. You are all children of light and children of the day. It's an advantage for us sitting here as Christians, as children of light, so that we can be aware of this calling as we practice wisdom. So this must be our constant hope and joy, brothers and sisters. As we hope in the Lord, we must be aware that the only thing that can separate us from the Lord is the fact of not using what has been entrusted to us in a good way and with the talents. So the need to always discern our action as stewards of creation. We need to always practice with discernment as the one God asks us to participate with Him with our talents in the construction of a just society for the poor. We need to always discern and then really embracing the things that move us closer to God and avoid the things that move us away from God. Like our founder, St. Ignatius of Loyola, founder of the Jesuit, would say, to embrace that through discernment. So once again, this is the importance of divine wisdom that will help us in our daily discernment. So if we ask God for the increase of His wisdom, we will know how to use our talents. And the teaching of the church, the sacraments, will accompany us in our journey of faith. It's not a journey that God asks us to do and then just abandoning us. The church as institution, His Holy Spirit will accompany us in our journey of wisdom. That's why today's passage from the book of Proverbs is key. It describes what I would call wisdom as a woman in the midst of a family. An example that woman marries and the joy with which she responds to her call and she uses her talents. That woman, that wisdom. Her main qualities are concern for the poor, prudence, kindness, and total love for her husband and children. That's the woman the first lady is talking about. I will quote, "She opens her hand to the poor and reaches out her hand to the needy. She opens her mouth with wisdom. In this way, she wisely employing her talents for the good of the society." So the way the book of Proverbs describes this woman, I would say humility is at the basis of her action. She's a humble woman, taking care of her family, responding to the call of being human. For Saint Augustine, in many ways, we need humility, as that woman describing in the first reading. Humility in order to respond with gentleness to our vocation and to apply our talents. Brothers and sisters, accept our weaknesses and approach God in humility to the sacrament of reconciliation with a humble heart is an act of wisdom. Humility is wisdom. In other words, it's a good way to discover God's grace in our life. Because the sacrament of reconciliation will give us what St. Augustine calls purification of heart, so that we can better receive Christ's teaching and Christ's comments on the sacraments, on the reading. The first reading says that women and children rise up and call her happy. As we can hear from the parable today, the way we use our talent responsibility is our key for the happiness mentioned in the first reading. It's not any happiness, it's the true happiness based on Christ's wisdom and guided by the Holy Spirit. Today, worthy of the poor, I must say that this happiness is what will lead us to the poor, to the needy. We need always, brothers and sisters, to discover God's proximity to our relationship with our brothers and sisters, especially those who need us. We are waiting for a God who is not far. We're waiting for Him, but He's not far away now. is not far away from us, is not far away from our daily reality. Because he's a God-made man. He's in the midst of us, but we're waiting for him. It's called dilemma. He is transcendent, but human, who shares our daily struggles, and who will give us his spirit. A God who is near, who invites us to live one of the greatest vocations we have received, being men and women, being steward of creation, that means great responsibility and entrusted to us. And by responding to them, we share God's image to the people we encounter, by responding to our vocation, by using our talents. Sometimes we must wonder what type of image of God we share to the people we live next to. The God of love, the God of forgiveness, the God of mercy, or the opposite of those things. Brothers and sisters, I would say the men that the parable mentioned represent Christ himself, the servants or the slaves or the disciples, and the talents or the gift that Jesus entrusts to us. These gifts, therefore, represent not only some physical qualities, but also the graces and riches that the Lord Jesus has given us as inheritance and invite us to make them bear fruits. Brothers and sisters, the church calls us today to a dynamic use of our talents that the Lord has given us. For this reason, as community, as church, we cannot ignore the reality of this world. We cannot ignore the poor. Don't have the attitude of the one who has not used his talents and who says to the master, "Lord, I know that you are a harsh man, that you reap where you do not sow and gather where you do not scatter." Don't use this attitude. Being responsible. Take care of the poor. Brothers and sisters, this parable of the talents teaches us to distinguish the true fear of God from the false one. The true fear of God is not fear, but rather a gift of the Spirit, by which we fear offending him, grieving him, and not doing enough to be faithful to his will. While the false fear of God is based on lack of trust, like the slave who sees one talent and say, "I know a harsh man, I didn't want to offend you." That's a false fear of God. I will finish this homily by this passage from the psalm, brothers and sisters. Blessed is everyone who fears the Lord. Those who fear the Lord walk in his way. That's the true fear of God. Let us always ask for the grace of knowing and loving God deeply, so that we can always choose his way and respond to the call of being men and women for others, especially for the poor.
Respond to our cause. The response will be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Church, working to establish peace and justice as we await the coming of God's kingdom. Clarice Mascarenhas, John Henry, Mathilde Arias, Cyril Climent, Maria Maloney, Piers Corsi, Diane Vanin, Ginny Whelan, Patricia Chauncey, Marilyn Cook, Doreen Martin, and Faith Gollard, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. We also pray in a special way for Giovanni and Brigida Lisi, and for Kate Taylor and Anne Snow, for whom this Mass is being offered. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For our own personal and private intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. Let us ask Mother Mary to join us in our petitions. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Lord Heavenly Father, in this day of the poor, hear our prayer, responding to our deeds, to Christ our Lord.
Amen. The offertory hymn is number 708, I Will Never Forget You.
Our duty and our salvation, always and give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons, and for men and women in your own image and likeness, and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. In the hope of the resurrection, all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that we be blessed, Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, his spouse, with the blessed apostles, all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, you may merit to be coerced to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but all I say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
I
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
A meeting of parishioners will be convened on Sunday, December the 3rd, immediately following our 9:30 Mass. Jacques Bouillieu has shown an interest in running for a second term as well. We need to elect two new wardens. If anyone would like to run, they must be 18 years of age and or older and reside within the boundaries of the parish. They will need to be present at the meeting and have someone propose their name and a seconder. Moving forward, all checks for hope must be made out to St. Aloysius Parish. Please write hope on the memo line. Most importantly, checks cannot be combined with donations to both hope and St. Aloysius Parish. Unfortunately, we will be returned to you otherwise. We are sorry for this inconvenience and appreciate your understanding. We have to thank Mike Lacombe, Pierre Pimont, Timothy Kaka, and Tony Secundo for putting up the winter shelter at the parish office. Thank you for volunteering your time so generously and the hard work of putting up the structure. Our 2024 collection envelopes will be available in the next few weeks. If you do not have a parish number and would like to receive a box of collection envelopes for tax purposes, please see Giovanni. Up until the end of December, all of Hope's collections will go towards our annual Christmas basket gift cards and adopt a child campaign. Once again, we are helping families from two local schools along with families in need in our community. We sincerely thank you in advance for your generosity. It is through your kindness that we are able to help those in need during the Christmas season. And Manon would like to add a few words.
Good morning.
Morning.
So regarding hope, I just want to remind you, as just Doc mentioned that all the collection took until the end of the year will be going towards the Adopt a Child and Christmas basket. So just to let you know, we have 22 families registered, and as of now, we have about 60 children. So that's quite a bit, and we can only do it with your help, and as in the past, we truly appreciate all the money you can give us. It's truly appreciated. And as of today, we will have a progress board with all the money collected on a weekly basis and what we have up to now. So I just want to thank you again and a reminder, that like every end of class, I will be in the back hoping for hope. So thank you and have a nice day.
You too.
Now, we are at the birthdays. So, on the 19th, which is today, Pius Corsi celebrates his birthday. On the 20th, it is Michel Narayana. On the 21st, Carol Wilson and Chelsea Russo. On the 24th, Melvin Reardon. And on the 25th, Lara Lanin and Marco Mastro Monaco. And so, we see. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, God loves you. Happy birthday to you. And there will be someone in the back hoping for hope, and our recessional hymn will be number 625, God Created Earth and Heaven. Furthermore, there is just one more thing. In the French sector, they are doing a petition to ask the food companies not to make so much profit, so that the prices of food are somewhat more reasonable, especially for the poor. So there is a petition in the back of the church that you could sign if you so wish.
Now let us stand for the final blessing to the sisters. And it was a blessing to really desire and celebrate the sacred Eucharist with all of you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. You too, Father.
And, sorry, I forgot to thank you. I always do that.
Thursday was my birthday.
Huh?
Thursday was my birthday.
Oh.